that's so bad, you didn't arrive. Like, yeah, I couldn't. I'm like, okay, don't worry.
We are now live. Oh, look at the dog. Oh.
Looking at the guy.
Not bad. Now remember.
Hello.
Hello. This is Pepe.
Bonjour. Bonjour.
A big shout out to Aida.
Hey.
Una, ¿cómo se dice shout out?
Shout out.
Un saludo, Aida.
Bonjour.
De Pauvi. Oh, take those glasses off again. Look at that. Look at Jose Vasquez, el poeta de Tijuana.
Aquí está.
Ex poeta. Ya es guía. Guía de turistas.
Mejor.
Mejor, mucho mejor. Ya. Y que sabes que realmente soy yo, tu anfitrión. Au revoir. still have my wallet and my keys. I was right here, over there, right over there, taking some video of the Riviera, of the river, when I heard this voice saying, excuse me, and without taking my camera off the river, I think now I should have filmed the person who was talking to me. I managed to glance down and see the woman kneeling on the ground about 3 feet in front of me, holding a golden ring in her hand as if she had just picked this up off the ground. Now, I had heard that this is a famous ruse with either with a gold ring or a coin or something of value, that the one person will ask you to take a look at it and see if it's yours or not, claiming to have just picked this up off the ground and maybe you dropped it. And while you move in close to this first person to take a look, the second person comes around and picks your pocket. So I'm sort of wishing now I had had the presence of mind to turn the camera right on her face, but I didn't. I was stubborn and kept filming the beautiful river over there. You can see it over there. Yes, filming the river behind me, around me, everywhere. And instead of filming her, I just held out my hand like this in her direction, as if to say, no, don't talk to me. And she went away. Well, I finished the shot and turn around to see where she'd gone, and she'd gone off towards the end of the bridge, down there where the street is, and she was looking around and trying to see if there was anything or anyone worth paying attention to. And pretty soon she was joined by a man, younger man than she. She was in her 40s or 30s. He looked to be in his 20s. So he was either a younger brother or maybe a son. And they went off together down the road over there, headed for the next stop. Now you can come out here and you can add your love to the bridge. You can even buy a lock right here. Just to add to the collection. But a reason I'm here is that building over there. That building was being built around the time that Thomas Jefferson was here in Paris. Now I want you to imagine that that was one of the taller buildings back then, and that this huge train station next door wasn't built. And those big apartments down there, stores. There were buildings there, but they weren't as tall. Now the dome was built around that time, so you may have seen that. And of course, he saw the towers of Notre Dame. The river makes a little bit of a bend, and then it splits around those islands down there. But coming back here to the north bank, the right bank, we see the end of the Louvre, or the west end of the Louvre. From there, the Tuileries Palace used to go across to meet with the other end of the Louvre over there in the trees. And this whole park here, all along here, all down there to that bridge, is the Tuileries. Yep. It's the Tuileries Park. And that piece of the end of the Louvre so frightened, I keep checking to see if anybody's pickpocketed me yet. Well, anyhow, the palace that went between that tower, or pavilion as they call it, and the other one that's over there in the trees, was called the Tuileries Palace, and it too would have been seen by Jefferson, since the Tuileries Palace was built beginning in the 1500s under the command of Catherine of Medici and her sons, her husband. She married the King of France, and her sons, one after another, were kings of France. And that palace burned down in the Commune of the 1870s. I forget what year it was, but it lasted for not very long, only about a year. And towards the end, they burned down that piece of the Louvre. Paris is a history of love and brutality. Of pleasure and violence. It is truly extraordinary.